All right, so our hand is pretty bad. Oh, wow. Fast bond. I feel like we're in some trouble here. Turn one fast bond. What, channel? What's going on? Oh my goodness. Wait. Our opponent has nothing. Okay. Well, not nothing, because... all right, well... You know what I want to draw? A Mock Sapphire. I mean, our opponent has four lands on turn two. Four mana on turn two, so that's already pretty absurd. But our opponent has no spells, really. Okay. Didn't have that last turn, so drew the Elvish Mystic this turn. Draw a card. Alright, there's our blue source. So what's funny here is I can play a looter, but I can also use my library as a looter. I don't know what's actually better. Like, for example, this turn I can actually, you know, discard one of my expensive creatures and then use the library again. But I guess that does use a mana source. And then the question becomes, do I want to play a Looter Ilkor or a card like a Gruul Signet? Because I can Entomb Unburial Rites. That's a play that we discussed before. You know what? I'm going to play the Looter. It kind of makes better use of our mana, and you know, we're still going to be able to use this library, but, like, you know, not being able to play a spell and discard is pretty bad, I think. All right, so here comes, all right, well, that's a deadlock. That is so greedy. That is the greediest thing I've ever seen. Holy cow. You know what? I'm going to mana screw you, man. I don't even care about your library. That's what our opponent's saying. I guess it makes some sense, because, like, our opponent doesn't have any threats, and just, like, our opponent's best bet at actually trying to beat us is to mana screw us, I think. So, sure. Alright, so we drew the Unburial Rites. I'm going to discard Dragon Lord of Tarka. Yeah, our opponent's not putting a whole lot of pressure on us. I can play this Gruul Signet, but I think I'm just going to pass and draw an extra card. So if you're hearing some rustling in the background, Kyle carefully spent the time to put almost all of his toy cars onto my table, then is now proceeding to knock them off the table one at a time. So what do I want to entomb? I guess just something I don't want to draw? I guess I can entomb like an Ulamog or something at this. I guess I can draw first and. Alright, let's cast Entomb. Ulamog or Dragonlord Silumgar? Yeah, I guess this is the card I want to draw the least, so. Let's draw. Man, our deck really does nothing. Ugh. Just our deck just does stone nothing. Okay. All right, we can do that. An island. Mean, at this point, do we actually need the library to draw cards? I think I just want to play out as much mana as I possibly can. Yeah. Like, we have a Sphinx's Revelation here too. Let's start developing our board. I didn't discard the Avenger of Zendikar because I could just cast it, and we have two great targets already. Know, depending on what our opponent plays next turn, if we're going to be in trouble, then we will, we'll discard Avenger and reanimate that. But right now, I think reanimating Dragonlord Tarka seems like the best play. Okay. All right, so we might be in some trouble here. Our opponent is. Oh God. Is this a Craterhoof Behemoth? No. Tooth and Nail? Ulamog? It's an Ulamog. Okay, I have no idea what this is. Is our opponent just scaring us? No, that can't. Play against two creature-based decks. Toxic Deluge might be pretty good. What's going on here? All right. Was that just like a straight bluff? Like I don't even know. All right. One, two, three, four, five, six. I kind of want to save Windswept Teeth. It seems pretty good with the Avenger of Zendikar. But then, what I want to discard? I guess I don't actually need Factor Fiction. Because the thing is, next turn I can play Avenger of Zendikar plus Windswept Teeth and make a bunch of dudes. Although, actually, let me think. Avenger of Zendikar might actually just be the best play here. What if I just discard Avenger of Zendikar? Oh no, I only get three tokens this turn. So no, that is in fact not true. Whatever, I'll just discard that. And give us a ton of mana. This guy. What do you have? Oath of Druids. Uh-oh. Wait, Oath of Druids doesn't even seem that great. Like, you're playing cards like Elvish Mystic in your deck. Oath of Druids doesn't seem like it's the kind of card. Like, in fact, I encourage my opponent to keep Oath of Druids in his deck after sideboard. All right, so some kind of green rampy deck. I think if we just do something similar to what we did last time, I think Sundering Titan is pretty bad. Rakdos Return is also pretty bad because our opponent empties the hand very, very quickly. Toxic Deluge is great. We do that, we can cut the mountain and add a forest. Garruk. Think that's all we did. I could play Abrupt Decay as well and cut something else. Don't know what that something else would be. What did we cut last time? Oh, we just cut survival. Yeah. This kind of just makes us more of a control deck. I'm not sure about the Ulamog. It is sweet, though, and our opponent can't kill it if we actually reanimate it, so it'll actually end the game pretty quickly. And Polychronos also seems like it could be good. The thing is, if you've noticed, we don't do enough things early, so being able to just like cast a Polychronos could be good, but when you only have six green sources, or sometimes seven for a double green card, I don't know if that's where you want to be. Like, it's just, you know, a lot of times you're just not going to be able to play a turn four, and that's where it really shines. I mean, we added a Garruk, a Toxic Deluge, and an Abrupt Decay as early interaction, and we ended up, you know, cutting Arrakis, Return, Sundering Titan, and Survival. So I think that should be enough to put it over the top. Gives us a few more things to do. This hand's pretty good. We have the Jace into the Reanimate, so with the Avenger. Oh God. Fastbond is such a scary card. Like, if our opponent has like a real draw, like, we can be in a lot of trouble. I don't even know though if green, like, if like a, the mono green strategy necessarily wants Fastbond. Just because, like, you already have a ton of good ramp sources. You know, you have your Tree Speaker, you have your Elvish Mystics and what have you, and this is just kind of puts you down a card. So unless you can do something completely busted, might not be at its best in mono green. Yeah, our opponent just played some lands and not actually casting anything, which means our opponent just has nothing. Oh. Or could have an Oath of Druids. Let's discard that. I guess I don't want to play a creature because our opponent's going to Oath something out. Don't really want to reanimate this turn. All right, let's see what our opponent oaths out here. Everything else goes into the graveyard. All right, hit a Raphelos. That is a ton of mana, so. Well, our opponent can't play any creatures now. Or our opponent will play a creature. Okay. Is our opponent killing the Oath of Druids now, or going to give us an activation here? I guess we've already drawn four of our creatures. I just hope we don't deck. But we have a reanimate, too. We can just do some pretty busted things here. I feel like the creatures that we get are just going to be far more powerful. Yeah, Elvish Mystic. Probably not the best play with an Oath of Druids on the board, but. Now we get to get some value here. Come on! What's the worst creature to hit? I guess Looter Ilkor. Choose target opponent controls. You control more creatures than me. Oh, hello. I want to give our opponent a bunch of mana. Actually, I don't. So, you know what? Here. This is, you know, you just get a creature every turn, and I am just going to go off here instead. Just discard Island here. What does more damage? Do I reanimate and make three tokens here? And then make them all 2/3s and 3/4s? Yeah. Instead of making four 1-2s. Or four two, we'd say 4-2-3s or 3-3-4s. I hope I have a land to get. Okay. All right. Do your worst. Hopefully that worst doesn't just kill us. Here it is. Here it is. Avacyn's Pilgrim. Yeah, this is precisely why you don't want Oath of Druids in your mana elf deck. You want Oath of Druids when you don't have a lot of creatures and all your creatures are huge. Oath of Druids are great in reanimator type decks. Like, for example, Oath of Druids would be a perfectly reasonable card for us to play in our deck. But all right, somehow made it to the finals.